This video is called Adding Polynomials. We know this is an addition problem because we have a polynomial here, a polynomial here, separated by an addition sign. So it's this adding sign that lets you know it's an addition problem. And when you add polynomials, you're looking for like terms. So you're looking for numbers that have the same ending. So for example, the 4 has an x squared attached onto it or multiplying to it. So does this 2. So they're considered like terms because the 4 and the 2 both have an x squared. So to combine them, 4x squared plus 2x squared will be a 6x squared. We have another pair of like terms. We have a positive 6x and a negative 9x. We know they're like terms because the 6 has an x attached to it, and so does the negative 9. Well, 6 plus a negative 9 is negative 3. So when you combine those like terms, you get a negative 3x. Lastly, we have two constants, a plus 7 and a plus 1. 7 plus 1 is a plus 8. So I look, I've combined all my like terms, and I have my answer in standard form because the exponents of 2 is the biggest. Exponent of 1 ending with my constant. One more example. This one, we know it's an adding problem because we have a polynomial and a polynomial with an adding sign or an addition sign between them. So we need to combine like terms. The 12m squared and the 8m squared are like terms because that both numbers have an m squared behind them. 12 plus 8 is 20. So to combine like terms, you have 20m squared. And then you have a plus 4 and a plus 5, two constants that when you add them together, you get a plus 9. This answer is in standard form because when you look at it from left to right, the exponents start at their biggest and end with the constant.